He knows.
It's a very unique thing to talk about.
Yeah, what? You know, the instrument is called kalimba in South Africa. It's called sansa in West Africa. It's called likimbe or mbira in East Africa. And you actually see in the hieroglyphics of the pyramid this particular instrument. So it has a long history. In English, we just call it the African thumb piano. But I was fortunate to study with a gentleman who passed last year by the name of Phil Coran, and he kind of introduced it to the United States, and he had two students. One's name was Maurice White, and the other was Kahil EL'Zabar. Maurice went into pop music, I went to jazz, so Maurice became famous. But we were his two students, and I'm the only one still living, so I got to keep it going. Moving, but very meditative kind of instrument. Yes, Aki.
No, I was trying to get you to
get mine?
Yep.
Yeah.
Me?
Yeah.
I'm right here. I'm all yours.
All right.
Go ahead. No, no, that's pretty much it. So, you know, the thing is, when I finished my bachelor's at Lake Forest, I came home. I had spent a year in Ghana. So I told my father, I said, I got this idea, you know. So he said, well, what's that, son? I'm going to put together a group that only has my percussion and two horns. So he said, no bass? I said, no. No piano? No guitar? No. He says, well, son, I don't see how you're going to make a living. you know, I explained to him that a lot of the music was, you know, based in the chromatic, you know, basic seven-tone scale in the Western perspective of music, but there are many perspectives, and I wanted to explore the pentatonic five-note scale systems and see how comprehensive I could compose, develop harmonies, and create a sound that would sing full without the usual instrumentation that people are used to. And so that was in 1973, so 2018, when I started the band, makes it 45 years. And in 86, I took my dad on a 20-month tour with Joe Bowie and Edward Wilkerson, who were in the Ethnic Heritage at that time. And my father was like, where are we right now? I said, we're in Amsterdam. Dad calls my mom, Quinn, you won't believe it. Girl, these fools are listening to this guy's music. They like it. Where were we yesterday? I said, we were in Milano, Dad. Yeah, we were in Milano. We're going everywhere. So then he got to the phone like this, you know, so I couldn't hear, but I'm here, and he told my mother, I think he's going to be okay. So 45 years, I'm very happy to be with these esteemed, incredible, really incredible musicians, sensitive, dynamic, intelligent, historically profound in their understanding of the music, and both just joyous, great heart human beings that you can see comes through their music. So we had a great time tonight. Thank you. Thank you, Shuka.
Thank you, Zaki. Thank you, Zaki.
Yeah.
How can we support you?
Yeah.
Well, you can post on social media because, you know, jazz is like a little bit, you know, like, I mean, you know, if this kind of performance happens and it's whoever, you know, in the hip hop world or whatever, you know, you blast it out and you're just part of this sort of sacred, I think. This is as close to sacred as...
This is our love.
You know, share it. Tell people about it. We have a musique on Saturday.
Thank you, George. So anyway, we have 64 recordings. So there are several recordings on iTunes, on Amazon, and stuff like that. There are over 3,000 videos on YouTube.
You need more than that.
We'll add more videos.
So, you know, there's a lot of information out there, and so this project is my love. So income comes from scoring more money for Columbia Pictures, Love Jones from New Line Cinema, How You Like Me Now, Universal Films. Those are all my film scores. The Lion King for Julie Taymor. So that allows me to do this and be in home and do this. But you're actually with four multi-award winning artists that are actually known all over the world, but this is what we do for our soul. And we hope we touched you.
So there it is. What more can be said? Okay.